Okay, and welcome back to another video of the DevScores platform. So, in these new series of videos, we're actually going to talk about Swift, what we can do with it, and what it is. And as an extension of our written articles on my website on devscores.com, you can actually watch the videos as well for a more immersive feeling of coding. So, Swift is the new main programming language built by Apple. And what it actually does, it is used to build iOS applications and macOS applications and tvOS and Apple Watch applications. Before that, it was Objective-C. And in 2014, when Apple announced the Swift programming language, they actually moved to Swift in general. I mean, there is nothing you can't do with Swift that you could do with Objective-C. And Swift is actually growing. These days, it's also used for building REST APIs and websites on Ubuntu. It's used to build on Windows. It's built for game development. It's used for game development, and you can actually also use it for machine learning using CoreML or TensorFlow. And stay tuned because I'm actually going to make videos about how you can build your own machine learning models using CoreML in the future. So, in this video, we're actually going to learn about variables, constants, and what we can do with them. And yeah, let's go to Xcode and let's get started. So we're gonna open up Xcode, and in Xcode we go to File, New, and we go to Playground. So, and the Xcode Playground is actually a place where you can play around with code, like the name suggests. We're gonna save this variables of constants. And what you can do in Playgrounds is actually you can test your code, and if it works in Playgrounds, you can put it in your own application. This is something we as developers like to do a lot. Instead of breaking our own whole application, you just test it in a separate project, and in this case in Playground. So I'm gonna delete this. So variables and constants are actually used for saving information. And what this means is every time when you start up a program, so for example, right now you start Xcode, everything that you see here, it's like sources, resources, all the names over here, those are actually all stored in a variable or in a constant, right? And those are all saved in memory. So every time when you start up a program, the program is put all the information from the variables and constants inside the system memory, so RAM. And the more variables you use, the more RAM your application uses. That is totally logical. So let's get started. So to start a variable, we're gonna do var name equals Johan. So Johan is my name. And what we did here, we called the variable attribute of var, we gave it the name of name, and we gave it a value of string, so value of my name. In this case, you can use your name as well. We're gonna create a new variable of last name. I'm gonna call this my last name, so it's us. You can do your own last name, of course. And we're gonna call another one for h equals 29. Okay, so as you can see, Johan, that's us, and age of 29. And as you can see now, the 29, we didn't have to put between the floating commas. And this is because it's an integer. So when you want to add a name, so a piece of text to a variable, you need a string. And in this case, we only use numbers. So an integer, we're gonna call 29. So we don't need the floating commas to in between. What we also can do with variables, we can actually print them out inside a console. So I'm going to do print of name, the second one, print of last name, and the third one we're going to call age. And as you can see here on the left side, we have this small run button. When we click that, you actually see that the values that we put into the variables are printing out inside the console. This is pretty cool. But this doesn't look really personal, right? Because there's no hi message and no introduction. So what we can do We're going to call print. And we're going to write a really nice message. And we're going to add those variables with string interpolation. And this means that we write hello, my name is backslash parentheses. And in here, we're going to call name. After that, we're going to call another backslash with parentheses. We're going to call last name. And after that, we're going to write we're going to do the same for age old. Now, here we have the button again. We click on run. And as you can see now, it prints a really nice message. Hello, my name is Johan. It's us, and I'm 29 years old. So we actually printed the values of our variables inside a really nice hello message. Pretty cool. One of the coolest things with variables is actually variables don't have like a fixed value. So in this case, my name is Johan and my age 29. What you can do, you're gonna call name equals string mark last name hot body. Oh, and we're gonna call age of 41. Yeah, so we've got here the equal sign. Okay, what we can do now, we're gonna call print. Oh yeah, we can copy this value over here, the same one. We can copy it, paste it, and now start again. So as you can see now, we have a new line in our console. Hi, I'm Mark Hotbody and I'm 41 years old. Swift is a really smart language. So Swift knows that always the last assigned value is the value that you have to print out. So in this case, this print statement actually prints out the information from the first variables. The second one, this one, prints information from these variables. So we're gonna create one more person. So we're gonna call her name, and we're gonna call her Lisa. We're gonna call last name, we're gonna call her Lightning, and she has an age of 21. And we're gonna paste our print again, and we're gonna run our program. And as you can see now, we actually have three users. So Johan, Mark, and Lisa. Pretty cool. But now we're actually gonna add some extra information, like social security number. And for this, we're actually gonna use a constant. So we go back to line 4, under age, and we're gonna call let social security number, so SSN. We're gonna give this some value. I have no idea how it looks, but 6, 7, 8, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so pretty cool. And what happens here is actually we can't change this anymore. So for example, for Johan, we're gonna add a new message, and my SSN is string interpolation, and we're gonna call SSN. Okay, let's print it. Let's run the program. As you can see now, Johan, so me, has my SSN in here. The problem is now when we also want to give Mark and Lisa an SSN, so we can call SSN equals 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We get an error. So cannot assign to value. SSN is a let constant. So in this case, we created a constant, and that means that the constant is always the same value, so it can't be changed. You can't assign another value to a constant. This is actually, security-wise, this is really interesting. So that, or even, not even security-wise, it's also really easy when you build like a really big application, and there is actually information that you don't want to have changed. You give it a constant, because when it's a constant, you don't have to worry about it when you work with a team that somebody else is changing the values and or they are calling the value or the variable or the constant and they give it a different value. You don't have to worry about it anymore because it's not possible. It's pretty cool. So we're gonna change this one back to a variable because we want Mark also to be able to have an SSN. Yes. SSN. And for Lisa, we're gonna give another variable. We're gonna give this I don't have a SSN. I'm an alien. Ooh, really scary. Okay, so we're gonna do two slashes. So two slashes, and that is commenting. So now we're gonna create a comment inside our code, and we're gonna give this. The comment of named variables. Oh no, wait a second. Assigned variables. So as you saw here above, we actually gave our variables already some information. What is also a possibility is instead of giving them value or giving them some information, you can actually assign a value to it. So this means, or a fixed value. So let's say we're gonna call var username string. So what we did here, we did actually the same that we did above here. So we created a variable of username, and the username is gonna contain a string. So instead of giving it a default value like Johan, we just assign it a value. Oh, so we don't need to add extra information to it. So what we can do now, we're gonna call username equals snowfall. Oh, we need a string there. Snowfall. We're gonna call another username for Mark is the Markinator. And the third one, username equals for Lisa, we're gonna give it lightning rod. Oh, we need to put this inside quotations. Rod. So let's print this out. And we're gonna give this new message, right? So our usernames are, now we're gonna give it double point, and we're gonna call username. And let's see what happens. So as you can see, in this case, our username is lightning rod. And that is because he calls the last lightning rod. So we have to call r to is and r to mine. My username is username. So what you can also do, let's delete the last two. And above you, on the username, we're gonna call var favorite game. I'm gonna give this string. And we're gonna call var level. And we're gonna call this int. Okay, pretty cool. On the username, we're gonna call favorite game equals Guild Wars 2 in my situation, and we're gonna call level is equals 80. So my username is username comma my favorite game equals let's delete this. Okay, so my username is username, comma, my favorite game is, favorite game, and I am level, I'm gonna call level. So let's print. Pretty cool. So as you can see, username string, favorite game string, and we assign the level of int. What is also a possibility, we can give this a double. So in Swift, you actually have three types of numbers. It's the integer, the boolean, the double, and the floating point. So in this case, we're going to call double, and we're going to call HP. Oh, sorry, var HP double point double, and we're going to call var MP. So MP is mana. We're going to give this a float. Pretty cool. What we can do here, we're going to call HP equals 4500.90. Okay, and we're going to call MP equals 4000.70. Okay, so what we did here, we created two new variables, one of HP of double and var MP of float. But as you can see, we actually almost assigned the same information, the same value to our variables. What's going on here? Okay, so the first one, the double, is 64 bits. This means that it can contain more than 10 characters behind the comma or behind the dot. So in this case, you could do 4500.9078 blah blah, and you're gonna get in, and so on, so on. So it's almost endless. With a float, is 32 bits, and this can only contain 10 numbers or 10 characters behind the comma. So 4500.12345678900. And this is all. So when you have like really, when you build like a calculator, you have like really big numbers like pi, for example, you're gonna use a double instead of a floating point, because when you use a floating point, it is not it will not be able to add more and more information, more characters behind the comma. So that's a little bit the difference between HP and float, or between double and float. And to be honest, I always like to use double, because if you use double, you're always sure that you have enough space there, and but you don't have to. I mean, it is all up to you. So we're gonna change MP back to double, because I like to work with doubles. And last but not least is boolean. So, and we're gonna call this is strong bool. Okay, so what a boolean does, a boolean is true or false. And this actually means that, for example, when you iterate to something with like a loop, and you want to check the value of something, then a boolean actually tells you if it's true or false. So under MP, we're gonna call isStrong equals true, and behind here we're gonna print a new print. Gonna give this a string, and we're gonna call I have string interpolation. We're gonna call HP, okay, comma, and I have MP. Okay, and then we're gonna call another print, and in here we're gonna give it a new string. And let's say, yeah, I never tell lies. Is this true? And after that, we're going to do string interpolation as well, and we're going to call is strong. So let's run this. Let's see what happens. So, my username is Snowfall, my favorite game is Guild Wars 2, and I'm level 80. I have 4500.9 HP, and I have 4000.7 MP. I never tell lies, is this true? And it returns true. So, pretty cool. So, in this video you actually learned how to use variables, how to assign values to them. We learned how to print. We learned string interpolation, and this means that we actually call the variables inside a string and we print those out into the console. We learned about constants, so that you, instead of using a variable, you can use a constant, and that way you can actually secure data and it's not possible to change. Pretty cool. And after that, we actually created a game character in our favorite game with a level. We learned about assigned variables, so that you assign a value to a variable, so like in string, integer, double, floating point, or a boolean. We learned the difference between a double and a floating point, and we actually printed some really cool information out. So as you can see, it's really easy. It's not rocket science, it's not difficult, and it's actually really fun to do. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I also hope that you learned something. If you want to see some of this information in written, we also have like written tutorials on my website on devscourse.com. And yeah, just make sure to check it out. And yeah, give this video a like if you liked it. Give it a thumbs down if you don't like it. And I see you next time.